Hello, my friend. My name is Anthony Digmann. I'm coming to you from Dyersville, Iowa, the home of the St. Francis Xavier Basilica, which you can see behind me, and also home of the Field of Dreams. I am so excited to be able to come back to the St. Isidore Catholic community this March, toward the beginning of the March, just so soon, right? Being able to come back to share with you some of the truths of our faith, especially related to the Eucharist and the National Eucharistic Revival. You know, it was such a blessing for me to be able to come up. I believe I was up in Osage for a confirmation retreat not super long ago, and it's so great to have the invitation to come back to talk about this Eucharistic revival. And I'm so excited to come join you for this opportunity. Now, you may already be aware of this, but our Eucharistic revival together is part of something much bigger. It's part of the National Eucharistic Revival that was called for by the United States Conference of Catholic Bishops, and it officially began the summer of 2022 on the Feast of Corpus Christi, and it's going to continue for 3 years. All the way up till 2025. But what are we going to be taking a look at in our mission time together? We're going to be taking a look at things across the board, from the teachings of the church, the traditions of the church, from the catechism. We're going to be taking a look at sacred scripture, going deep into parts of sacred scripture, and looking at Jesus's authentic teaching of the Eucharist, that he is really present, body, blood, soul, and divinity in the Eucharist. And I have to admit to you, my friend, that I am a naturally skeptical person. So for me, I'm a bit of a doubting Thomas. It takes evidence to support and supplement my faith in the Eucharist, and I'll be sharing all of that story with you during our Eucharistic Revival talks as well. We're going to be taking a look at saints' testimonies of the Eucharist and the importance of the Eucharist, and a whole bunch of some of my favorite things, Eucharistic miracles. We'll be taking a look at a whole bunch of those as well. So a whole bunch of things to help us go deeper into our faith with the Eucharist, appreciate it, where it came from, why we believe Jesus is really present, body, blood, soul, and divinity in the Eucharist, but also to help us answer questions that we may have ourselves, or questions that may be had by coworkers or friends or family or our children or maybe even our parents, that we can help others come to appreciate the Blessed Sacrament more and more as well. Unfortunately, it's a really common occurrence within our Catholic faith that some people we love and people we care about have left the faith. Maybe it's siblings, maybe it's children, maybe it's our parents, maybe it's our neighbors. But the Eucharist is really something incredibly special about our faith and unique to who we are as Catholics, that we really have the bread and wine really turned into the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus Christ. So our ability to understand this at its full level of what Jesus Christ truly is, and this gift that the Eucharist truly is for our church, and then our ability to then share that truth with others, is absolutely vital. Our Eucharistic Revival series together should be very enriching, both for our heads and for our hearts, so that we can understand this gift that we have in the church, this most paramount of all of these sacraments given to us by Jesus himself, and this greatest of gifts, because it really is Jesus Christ himself. And then what we can learn from the Eucharist, the fruits of the Blessed Sacrament for our own spiritual life, for our church, and for the entire world. So I am so excited to come share this with you. So let me also share a little bit about myself. I've been married now for 16 years. I have 3 children. I just published my 4th book. I'm a Catholic author and speaker. I've been doing this for about 7 years now. I have a master's degree in theology, and I'm also currently working on a master's in catechetics and evangelization from the Franciscan University of Steubenville in Ohio. And I've had the gift, the joy, the pleasure, the challenge over the last 15 years of teaching Catholic high school theology. I am so excited for this gift, this opportunity to get to come to share the truths of our faith with you and with your parish, that I may be enriched, that you may be enriched, that your whole parish, family, community, diocese may be enriched by the beauty and truths and goodness that Jesus Christ has given to us in our Catholic faith. Know of my prayers for you as we anticipate coming together again. I invite you to come, bring some friends, bring some people to share the truths of our Catholic faith. You know, sometimes it's kind of hard to share our faith with others, to bring up a topic that may be difficult, but inviting them to an event to come hear some crazy speaker from Iowa talk about the truths of our faith, that's not super hard. So feel free to invite a lot of people, your neighbors, your coworkers, your friends, your parents, your kids, aunts and uncles, siblings, whoever, bring them along with you so that we can explore more deeply our faith together. God bless you, and you'll be in my prayers.